You might have heard that there's a really important climate report coming out today. It makes for some pretty bleak reading, and to be honest, I'm not ashamed to admit that I actually cried when I read it for the first time. Not because it contains anything we didn't know already, but because it's just so much more overwhelming when it's all together in one place like that. Climate change is happening right before our very eyes. Recent events across the world only emphasise that. From the devastating wildfires in California, Turkey and Greece, to floods in England, Belgium, Germany, to the heat waves we're seeing in Siberia and Canada. This report reminds us of what we already know, that these kinds of events will only become more frequent and more hard-hitting with ongoing warming. The report covers the physical science of climate change, or in climate jargon, the findings of Working Group 1 of the IPCC. And if you're not familiar with the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC to its mates, you can think of it as a kind of a group representing the collective view of all climate scientists, so a kind of consensus. The IPCC is a really amazing and fascinating group, so if you're interested in how it works and why it's so important, then Climate Adam has a really wicked video on the subject, so make sure you bookmark that one to watch later. They've also done a really brilliant video on the content of the report, as has Zentoro, so make sure you head over to both of their channels straight after this when you've finished watching this video. But now, the content. And for the avoidance of any doubt, the report says it's unequivocal that human activity has changed the planet and that widespread and rapid changes in the atmosphere, ocean, cryosphere and biosphere have occurred. Now, this report is chock-a-block with information and it's way too much to cover in one video. So for this one, I've just chosen to draw out the main things that the IPCC say about the cryosphere. Let's start with sea ice. Sea ice is a good one because it's one of the most important health indicators of the planet, and it's also part of a crucial feedback loop that can amplify or accelerate the warming or cooling of the planet. When we lose bright white sea ice, it exposes darker ocean beneath, which absorbs energy and warms up further, and that causes more sea ice to melt and then more warming to happen, and that's a reinforcing cycle. The IPCC finds that human activity is responsible for the 40% reduction we've seen in Arctic summer sea ice extent since 1979, and that summer sea ice area is probably lower than any time it's been in the last 1,000 years. Looking ahead, and it just gets worse. By mid-century, the Arctic is expected to be practically ice-free in summer under high and mid-range emission scenarios, which are looking increasingly like the most likely scenarios we're going to get given our current pathways. However, this might even be a conservative estimate, because many Arctic sea ice specialists that I've spoken to recently are hedging their bets on something a little bit closer to 2035. Now, the Arctic is already warming by 3 times the global average, and this looks very likely to continue, and that will drive the loss of snow, land ice, sea ice, and permafrost. The world's glaciers are hemorrhaging ice, driven of course by human activity. And the wholesale retreat of glaciers across every single corner of the globe hasn't happened in the last 2,000 years at least. So that gives you a scale of what we're doing. The world's 2 main ice sheets in Antarctica and Greenland have also been shrinking, and the fingerprint of human activity is clear in Greenland at least. The picture is a bit more complex in Antarctica, but at any rate, the amount of ice lost from ice sheets has quadrupled since 1992, making ice loss from glaciers and ice sheets the dominant drivers of sea level rise in the last 20 years. The report doesn't suggest this is going to lessen anytime soon either, with glaciers and ice sheets expected to carry on melting for centuries. It's virtually certain that sea level will rise over the 21st century, but how much it will rise is still kind of up to how many greenhouse gases we spat into the atmosphere. My words, not theirs. Over the longer term, sea levels could rise by huge amounts. We're talking 22 metres over the next 2,000 years. So, goodbye civilization. And one of the scariest parts of this report is the references to irreversible changes and low probability, high impact outcomes, i.e. the point of no return. For instance, if all the permafrost in the polar regions thaws, it ain't coming back over the timescale of centuries, and sea levels will continue to rise for millennia. Worse, sea level rise above the likely range, so we're talking 2 meters this century, 5 meters by 2150, and scary high risk events like ice sheet collapse, forest dieback, and abrupt ocean circulation changes can't be ruled out. Now, there's a lot of new science in this report, and our models have improved vastly in the time since the last one, but there are still massive question marks around the science of tipping points and the thresholds for these kind of scary, irreversible changes. Nevertheless, the basic message of this report is the same one that scientists have been banging on about for decades. The climate is changing, it's because of us, and it's about time we did something about it. Every IPCC report comes with stronger evidence for the damage we are doing to our planet. This time is no different. Nothing in here is surprising, but it should be a wake-up call. As the report says, every tonne of CO2 emissions adds to global warming. So what we do now has never been more important.